Hello, today we shall see some numericals on winding. So coming to the first problem, we have been given the empty diameter of a spindle-driven cylindrical package as 5 centimeters. The spindle speed is given as 2000 rpm and the traverse speed is 100 meters per minute. We are asked to find out the winding angle, the winding speed and the angle of wind at the beginning. And also the winding speed and the angle of wind when the package diameter becomes double. So we know the formula of winding speed, which is equal to entire square root of surface speed square plus traverse speed square. So surface speed can be calculated by pi into d into n, which is given as 5 centimeters, and 2000 is the spindle speed, which is also the package speed. Divide this by 100 because we wanted the answer in meters. So we get the answer as 314 meters per minute. Calculating the winding speed would be entire square root of 100 square, that is the traverse speed which is given to us, plus 314 square, and the answer would be 329.53 meters per minute. So tan theta could be calculated traverse speed upon surface speed, which we have just calculated, and the answer is 0.318. Theta, we can take a tan inverse of this value, and we get 17.66 degrees. So the same thing needs to be calculated for a package diameter when it becomes double. That means the diameter of the package is now 10 centimeters instead of 5, which was given to us. So surface speed we can calculate as pi dn as before, and the answer is 628 meters per minute. Winding speed we can again calculate in a similar way, entire square root of 100 square plus 628 square, and the answer is 635.91 meters per minute. And tan theta would be traverse speed upon the surface speed, which is 0.159, and theta is 9.04 degrees. So with that, we come to the next problem. A cheese of 150 mm traverse length is wound on a rotary traverse machine equipped with 75 mm diameter drums of 2.5 crossings. Calculate the winding speed and the coil angle if the drum rotates at 3250 rpm. So first thing that we need to calculate is the winding speed. Again, the same formula. Surface speed I can calculate by pi dn. We have been given the values here, 75 mm. So this would be the meters per minute answer as 765.76. So traverse speed, I can write it as 2 into traverse length into rpm of drum divided by number of revolutions per double traverse, which easily can be written for better memory as 2 ln upon s, which is 2 into traverse length that is given as 150 mm here, which is converted into centimeters. So it is 15 into rpm of drum is 3250 divided by s. S is the number of revolutions per double traverse. Here the crossings is given as 2.5. So number of revolutions per double traverse is double of it, that is 5, and divide by 100 because I want to convert this answer in centimeters per minute to meters per minute. And just a tip here that S is the traverse ratio actually. Winding speed is equal to entire square root of surface speed square plus traverse speed square. So we get the answer is 790.2 meters per minute. And with the above values, we can easily calculate theta also. It is traverse speed upon the surface speed. So tan inverse of 0.255 would give me theta, which is 14.3 degrees. But we have been asked to find out the coil angle. Coil angle is nothing but 90 minus theta, that is angle of wind. And so coil angle would be 75.7 degrees. Coming to the third problem, the diameter and length of the drum of a random winder is nothing but a drum winding machine, is 100 mm and 300 mm respectively. If the drum is rotating at 4000 rpm and crossings on the drum is 3, then calculate the slippage if winding speed is 1200 meters per minute. So again, we can find out winding speed by the same formula pi dn, and the answer is 1256 meters per minute. We can find out the traverse speed 2 ln upon s. So 2 into traverse length, which is 30 centimeters into 4000 is the rpm of the drum, divided by the number of crossings are given as 3. So the traverse ratio would be 6 multiplied by 100. This is actually 100 is there because I want to convert the centimeters to meters again. So it is 400 meters per minute. Both these units should be same. When we calculate winding speed, the answer is 1318.16 meters per minute. So to find out slippage would be, you can directly calculate from 100 minus efficiency of the machine that is there. That is equal to 100 minus 1200 is the actual speed that is given. And this is the expected speed that we have just calculated above. And when you divide this multiply by 100, we get the efficiency of the machine. And when I subtract that from 100, what I would get is the loss in production or the length delivered because of a slippage that is there. So calculating this, we get slippage to be 8.96%. Coming to the next problem, we have been given the data on a cheese. The cheese having 150 mm height and 50 mm core diameter and 125 mm maximum diameter is being wound on two different machines as follows. The situation is like this particular cheese is wound on both drum driven as well as spindle driven precision winder, and the data is given as drum diameter is 75 mm and the drum makes 5 revolutions per double traverse, whereas the spindle speed of a precision winder, it rotates 6 times per double traverse is given. So for machine A, we have been asked to find out the traverse ratio as package diameter 50 mm and 100 mm. For the machine B, that is the precision winder, we have been asked to find out the angle of wind at the same two different diameters, that is 50 and 100 mm. So first let us look at machine A, which is a drum driven winder. So traverse ratio at a certain package diameter will be traverse ratio of the drum multiplied by diameter of the drum divided by diameter of the package at that point of time. So substituting the values here, traverse ratio of the drum, which is given to us as 5 revolutions per double traverse, multiplied by diameter of the drum, which is given as 75, and the first package diameter, that is 50 mm, I get the traverse ratio as 7.5 at the package diameter of 50 mm. In a similar way, I can calculate the traverse ratio at 100 mm diameter, which is 5 into 75 upon 100. Answer is 3.75. It is observed that the traverse ratio in case of a drum driven winder decreases from 7.5 to 3.75, which is expected because we already know the theory behind this. As the package diameter increases from 50 to 100, the traverse ratio is bound to decrease, which can be seen from these figures. Coming to the second part of the problem about precision winder, we have been asked to find out the angle of wind, and therefore we use this formula: tan theta is equal to 2 into traverse length divided by pi into d into traverse ratio. So substituting, I get 2 into 150 divided by pi into diameter, that is 50, that is the first package diameter, multiplied by traverse ratio, which we have been given as 6 over here. So we get the value of tan theta as 0.3184 and theta as 17.67 at a package diameter of 50 mm. Similarly, we can calculate the figures for the package diameter at 100 mm. So substituting 100 over here instead of 50, we get the answer as theta to be 9.05 at a package diameter of 100 mm. And it is from the above figures, it is observed that the angle of wind in case of spindle driven winder decreases from 17.67 to 9.05, again as expected as per our theory, as the package diameter increases from 50 to 100 mm. We can easily see the values decreasing from 17 degrees to 9 degrees. Coming to the next problem, for a spindle driven winder, when the package is 10 centimeters, the winding angle is 20 degrees. Determine the angle of wind when the package diameter is 15 centimeters. And the second part of the problem, in a drum driven winder, the angle of wind is 30. The drum having 5 centimeters diameter makes 5 revolutions for one double traverse. Calculate the length of the winding drum. So let us see the part A of the problem. For a spindle driven winder, tan theta is equal to traverse speed upon surface speed. for tan theta is constant, this traverse speed is constant, that's why we write constant here in the numerator divided by pi d n. And again, we can see that the n and the pi being a constant, it is a constant upon d, and therefore d tan theta is going to be a constant. D tan theta is constant from start to the end of the package. In the above problem, therefore, in the first case, it is 10 centimeters diameter, angle of wind is 20. We have been asked to determine the angle of wind when the package is 15 centimeters. So substituting, we get the value of tan theta by rearranging this. And from the value of tan theta, by taking a tan inverse of the value, I can get theta as 13.64 degrees. For drum-driven winders, tan theta is equal to traverse speed upon surface speed, which is 2 into traverse length divided by pi into d into traverse ratio. So 2 into traverse length divided by pi into d, which is given as 5 centimeters diameter, and it makes 5 revolutions. So substituting, which is equal to tan 30, the angle of wind is given as 30. So traverse length can be easily found from this particular formula, and we get it as 22.67 centimeters. There is a small mistake over here, that is, this is not traverse speed, it is traverse length, which is 22.67. A precision winder with a constant spindle speed is being used for the production of cheese. The traverse length is 150 mm and the traverse ratio is 6. If the minimum angle of wind is 8 degrees, determine the maximum package diameter. So since it is a precision winder, the angle of wind decreases as the package builds up. We know this from our theory. Therefore, when the maximum angle of wind is given, it means that it is a value of angle of wind when the package diameter is maximum. So whenever package diameter is maximum, the angle of wind would be minimum. So with this theory in at the back of our mind, we can always say that whatever calculation or the package diameter we get, it would be maximum since angle of wind that has been given to us is minimum, which is 8 degrees. So using this particular formula, 2 into traverse length into double traverse per minute upon pi dn, this n actually, this traverse, double traverse per minute can be written as RPM upon traverse ratio. So when I cancel the RPM of the spindle in the numerator and denominator, I get the formula as 2 into traverse length divided by pi d into traverse ratio. Substituting all the values except the value of d, which we need to find out, we get the answer as 11.33 centimeters, which is the maximum cheese diameter which is asked in the problem. So with this, we come to the end of numericals. Thank you.